Okay. So, what's our common denominator, Teresa? 2y. So, we're going to have to times the first one by 2. Then the 4 over 1 by 2y. Then this one is 2y. So I get 6 over 2y plus 8y over 2y equals 3 over 2y. What's my next step, Mason? Now you can cancel out the two y's right away, or you can put them together and then cancel them out, but either way it's fine. And you'd get, before you cancel, you'd say y can't equal 0. Yeah. And what I always do is I go to the end and I go like this. The very bottom of my page, right where my answer is going to be, I put y can't equal 0. The reason why I do that is so that I remember to check for extraneous roots. Because there's so many times that you guys will do all the work correctly and you'll forget to check if your answer is one of the non-permissible values. And then you tell me it's right or you circle the multiple choice that has that answer in it and then you'd be wrong. Right? So we have to make sure we always check it. So I always put my MPVs back there. So you can either cross this off right away or you can put this together as 6 plus 8y over 2y equals 3 over 2y and cross it off. Either way, you get the same thing, right? So we get 6 plus 8y equals 3. Subtract my 6. 8y equals negative 3. Divide by 8. Y equals negative 3/8. And look, it's right beside my non-permissible value. Do they match? No? So it's good. If they matched, you'd say it can't equal. Okay? For the next few minutes, I'm going to have you work on a few questions. And then we're going to finish the hard ones tomorrow.